Okay everyone, so welcome back to Angler Carl. Now in this video today I am going to be doing a bit of lure fishing. Now I have got, or I've ordered a chest mount for the GoPro, so just stay tight because I'm having to do a bit of a weird setup with the GoPro at the minute. So if the stabilization isn't fantastic, it's because I've made a makeshift thing for me tripod, and also as well I just think having the chest mount will give you people a better view. Also, another thing I've noticed with the lure fishing videos, they've not been doing too well for views. So if you do watch this and you do like it, make sure you share the video around. And also let me know if you enjoy seeing this type of content, because like I said, the reason why I want to do this type of content is because I think it's enjoyable, it's something different for you people to watch. Now, as you can probably see, this is the reason why I've come lure fishing, because we've had a lot of snow and the temperatures have plummeted, and to be honest with you, I don't fancy being sat on the bank. And it's, I think it's literally, it must be about 0 degrees or 1 degree. So I'm coming out in the freezing cold, and for the first time I think on this channel we're doing river pike fishing or chub, if we can get chub, which I doubt it. And also we're going for perch if we can get perch, but the main target is pike. I've got the wire trace on, I just need to attach a lure. I'm going to use the white Temu one from last time, but god, it's like a winter wonderland out here everyone. So like I said, join me as we go on this crazy river session. Do you think we're going to blank, or do you think we're going to catch? I think there's a good chance we're going to blank. Now I'm going to have to switch the camera off because I have no idea where I'm going. I've parked in the car park, but I don't see no river anywhere, so I've probably gone past it. But check out that, it's absolutely covered in snow and my hands are already freezing cold. I'm gonna have to probably get some gloves at some point. So yeah, next time I join you will be when we've found out where this bloody river is. Also as well, get subscribed to the channel. We've been getting quite a lot of subscribers lately, so make sure you show the lure fishing some love by hitting that subscribe button, and post your comments down below as always, and share this video around, that is very important. Okay, so I think I might have found where the river is. I think it's just over where that white fence is. I'm not sure if you people can see in the distance, but that's what it looks like to me. Now I've got to somehow try and find a way to get over that side and onto that field that looks very snowy. And also, yeah, I've got to be careful when you explore a new area that you've never been. You've got to be quite careful. I did find another spot back up the top end and stuff, so I might go back there because I'm probably missing a lot of the river. So I did find a little pathway. Obviously I want to be careful, I don't want to go trespassing on anyone's land or stuff like that, because you know that's not what I want to do. But like I said, I did see a little bit where I walked down, and I reckon if I can get over there and get over that side, then we'll be absolutely golden, because this is actually just a path where you can just do a walk. So if you fancy coming for a scenic walk by yourself or with the other half, then this bit's good. It's actually the Wharf, I believe it's the Bolton on Dearne stretch and what have you people. I'm not entirely sure of the exact one, but I'm thinking this bit looks like a pathway to heaven. So if we go down here, I'm just gonna take you people down this bit. Always watch your step as well everyone and what have you. This is absolutely crazy, and there is like a fence here, so oh man, wowzers. Right, so somehow I've got to try and get over this big fence. So I think what I'm going to do is chuck the rod over and somehow climb over, because right near where that fence is over there, I tell you what a beautiful winter's day. I reckon that's where we're going to get to the river, because there's no other access point that I can see. I believe it's barbed wire, so we're going to have to be very careful. I think I'm going to have to take the net off my back as well, or otherwise we're not getting over. So the first thing I'm going to do is put the rod over. I tell you what, everyone, if we don't catch a fish, we're doing this, then I don't think we're ever going to catch one. Luckily, I am quite tall. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to chuck the net over as well. And then I'm literally going to try and climb over, and I'll join you if we get over to the other side. This is becoming more of a fun exploration rather than a fishing video. But hey, if this isn't worth subscribing for, I don't know what is. Let's try and get over this crazy fence. So good news, everyone, we are over the fence, and this is what we are greeted with. It's an absolute winter wonderland, everyone, this. It's crazy. So I'm hoping that the river is around this bit, because if not, I've just literally gone over a fence for absolutely nothing. By the way, I'm sorry if the sun's shining, but what a beautiful day, I will say. One thing river fishing does is it takes you to some crazy places. Now, obviously, I have got the Advanta boots on, which was good. And this looks like we've made it to the river, which, yeah, I'm buzzing about, really. So let's have a look. These banks, though, look bloody steep. Here she is. We've made it, everyone, to the river. I'm slightly worried that the banks are going to be very, very steep and slippery, so I've really got to be careful where I put my feet. And there we go, everyone, this is the river. And as you can see, there's a good overhanging tree there where I can have a cast in. And as well, a little tip if you are doing lure fishing, one thing I would do is always make sure you have your phone handy with you to look where you got over from the access point and stuff like that, because for me, it's a very good idea. So I'm going to get a lure on. I think the first one I'm going to go with is probably the old faithful spinner, or I might go with the Temu lure, but I don't know. I feel like I'm going to go with the spinner first, because I just feel like that's what's going to be better. And it is going to be, unfortunately, a bit difficult to get the tripod set up properly, because if you can see by this bank, it's just absolutely uneven as anything. I mean, it's going to be tough to even net a fish, let alone anything else. I might just be able to net it down that bottom end. These little drop-off points that I think would be good that we could do. So yeah, what I'm going to do, if I did get a fish, I would get it unhooked in the net and show you people on camera, and then I'll be just doing like little snippet updates for this till we can get his chest, his little chest mount thing. So please bear with me while we wait to get the chest mount, and then we can start doing like proper stuff. So yeah, let's get a lure chucked in, or a spinner, and let's see if we can get anything on this absolutely freezing cold day. Right, everyone, bit of an update. I'm back on the path because I had a little cast in that bit of river, but it didn't feel good. I have seen a bit where the water comes rushing into the river. Now, the main thing I want to have a look at is if I can get down, because I don't want to have to feel like I've got to jump or anything. I can't really access it from this side, but it's very difficult to get down to. So I'm going to show you people what I've scoped out. And to me, it doesn't look like I'd be able to get over. And this is the bit I'm talking about. You might just be able to see it. There's like a little outlet thing. There's a bit down here that I might be able to get to. I might be able to like scurry through them bushes and get to it. So let's actually see if we can do that, and that might be a better idea, and then at least we can stay on this side and then we don't have to risk walking around that side. Right, success, everyone. We've managed to get to this bit where there's like a big sort of floor, and I'm gonna have a couple of casts with the spinner, and then I'm gonna switch it over to a lure, and then the plan is to just carry on walking downstream to see if we can get out. So let's see if this spot produces anything. Okay everyone, so absolutely nothing on that one. The only thing I ended up with was a snagged spinner that I had to cut off, and yeah, lure fishing is demoralizing at times. I still seem to love it and I still seem to enjoy it, and I think that's just the angler within me. So we're gonna move away from that spot. I think the reason why it probably got snagged was because it's got trebles, and trebles are really easy, you know, to get snagged. And then, to be honest, I don't know much about this river, but for me, most rivers that I seem to fish, well, sorry, what I mean is, I've fished other parts of the Dearne before, and it's always seems to be very snaggy, which is a bit of a pain in the backside. So I'm using, if I can show you on the GoPro, this Temu lure. It's a white one. So I used this lure on the last video that I did, which we had that follow by that pike. So I'm gonna walk further downstream and just basically see if we can get anything further down. I've obviously got to be careful because I don't want to use up all the memory on my GoPro. I do need to get a bigger SD card. But yeah, let's see if we can walk further downstream, find a nice little spot and fish in there. Hopefully we can catch one, but if we don't, it's one of them things, we keep coming back. Newsflash everybody, we've still not caught anything. The only thing that's happened again is we've got snagged again. We literally got snagged again, everyone. I tried everything. I tried doing the little bow trick. If you've never heard of that, it's basically where you twang the line and normally your lure comes off, but this time it didn't. I'm beginning to lose faith, everyone, with this session, because like I say, at the minute, nothing's happening. Obviously the river is quite clear, and I'm actually using, I don't know if you can see that on the GoPro, but I'm using a silver lure. I've got to be careful though with the snags, because that's twice that we've got snagged up and lost as lures. This is why I only buy cheap lures. I would never buy expensive ones. That's why I get a lot of mine off Temu, because I'd be going through a hell of a lot of money. So I'm gonna just chuck in here, in this little bit here, and then we'll keep walking down. But so far, everybody, this session's not going well. I will say this though, it's a lovely river and it's an absolute lovely winter's day. So that's one good thing. And I guess you just have to think about that when times are getting really tough. But hopefully one day we'll have better sessions than this. But stay tuned, you never know, fishing's a weird one. Right, so I'm not having much luck on finding spots at the minute, everyone, because this is the problem we've got. I don't know if you can see that on the GoPro, it might be difficult to see, but in the edges it's very snaggy. And when I'm using sort of this type of jig head, it's just going to get literally snagged up to the high heavens. So that is why I'm being really picking out my spots, because I've been snagged about three times. I think it's three times, everyone, I've actually forgot. We did get snagged recently, but we did manage to get the lure free by doing the little bow trick. But for me, this river, I mean, if you look down here, it's just absolutely snided in snags, everyone. And to be quite honest with you, I don't want to be going in them, you know. I don't want to be sort of getting tangled up all the time. It's just not worth it to me. I am losing confidence, I'll be honest, everyone. I'm losing confidence in the spot. Yeah, it just doesn't feel good to me. Like I say, I mean, I am looking, I am trying to get some weedless hooks, because I know that will change it up a little bit and what have you. But if you look here, this is a perfect example. Just look at all that right in the edge there. You know, you're not gonna be, you know, you're not gonna be catching any fish anytime soon from there. So I'm losing confidence. I have fished another stretch of the Dearne before, and It was actually better than this. I once actually had a pike, but this spot is terrible. You know, it's really, really snaggy and what have you. Let's try this bit. Whoa, obviously got to be careful, everyone. And the problem is can I get a net down into there? And that is the ultimate problem. So this bit doesn't look too bad. I'm gonna have a cast near that tree and then to the far bank, and then see if we can potentially get up from that way. But I think if we get snagged again, everyone, I don't know, I might have one more go at it and then call it a day. But I'll give this bit a go and see if we can get out. So I found a pretty nice spot just near this tree here, and lo and behold, it actually wasn't too snaggy. I've done a couple of casts up to the far bank and the tree. Like I said, I'm sorry I can't show this on camera. There's just no real good place to put the GoPro. So like I said, hopefully my chest mount will come soon enough. But like I say, yeah, that's I just was casting where that tree is, and yeah, unfortunately it didn't produce anything. But I'm gonna keep walking down because we're not doing bad for time. We've still got probably nearly 2 hours and stuff, providing, you know, we haven't got a ridiculously long walk back to the car. So I think there's a road coming up where there might be a bridge where I can cast under. So I'm hoping and praying that that'll be the case. My biggest worry today was the snow on the bank, but luckily it's not proving too much of a problem. So let's see if we can find any more good spots, and I really hope we can get a river pike, but it's not looking good, is it? I've just spoke to some passerbyers and they seem to think that this is one of the more difficult stretches, which, yeah, that doesn't faze well for me. So I think what we're gonna do, everyone, we're gonna go back to them spots that I found at first that was like not as snaggy, and then what we're going to do is swap over. I think I've got a few different layers. I don't want to go put in the spinner on, because with it having the treble hooks, it's just going to get snagged in everything like the first one did and stuff and what have you. So I think that's going to be the best thing to do, to be honest. And then we'll go back to the original spot where we was, where the water was flowing quite fast, to see if there's any little pike just waiting for some roach or what have you, and then we can just walk straight back up and call it a day. But yeah, it's just been one of them sessions and what have you where it's not gone as planned. I definitely won't fish this stretch again, just because sometimes you can get a bit of a gist if sort of is good for lure fishing. I will be joining an angling club that has access to loads of stretches of canal and rivers, which is going to be awesome content for the channel. I will tell you people more about that further down the line when I get that membership, because it's always good to support local clubs and stuff like that. And let's be honest, it's going to be awesome fishing all the different rivers and canals for pike and perch. At some point I might do some drop shotting with worms. So I've managed to get under where this bridge is, everyone, so I'm gonna have a cast under this bridge with the lure and see if we can get out. Now it does look a bit rocky, a bit snaggy, but normally bridges are really good. And then I might have a little chuck up this bit. I'm just gonna stand away from the spot because I don't want to spook the fish if there is any. And also there's that little waterfall back there that we fished before. It's been a bad one today. Hopefully we can find some on here. I've got my fingers crossed, but I'm not hopeful. Yeah, we had to walk a bit further down the road, sort of like walk across the bridge and do it that way. But yeah, let's have a search under this bridge. Thank you. So then, everyone, we got snagged once again. I did cast near that tree. Now, funnily enough, I actually did a really good cast. I didn't get stuck in the tree. There was just clearly a snag under the water. And I'm not going to lie, this stretch of the river has been absolutely terrible. You know, it's shocking, shocking stretch of river for me personally. I just don't think it's good. I literally even casted down to where you people can see that waterfall, and it's not been very good. So yeah, it's just one of them things, you know. Some people will come and fish it and maybe have great days, and some people come like me and have absolutely terrible days. And obviously I'm doing lure fishing, so you know, maybe different tactics, maybe if you're using a feeder or a pole, that might work differently for you. But it's been nice to get out and stretch the legs, everyone, but it's not been a great session at all. And I did even cast under this bridge. I mean, check that graffiti out, look at that. I tell you what, that does look quite cool on the GoPro, everyone. Yeah, that is awesome. I think that'd make a good, to be honest, I think that might make a good thumbnail. So then, everybody, that is another blank on lure fishing. And to be honest, it's just one of them things. It happens, it's fishing, and there's nothing you can do about it, unfortunately. It is just one of them things. Like I mentioned previously, I think the best thing now for me to do is to join the club and go on some club canals and also some club rivers, because I think we're going to have better luck there. And I've also read up on some of the rivers and they are very good fishing. Does it still mean we're going to catch? No, it doesn't. Obviously, we have to get his tactics right. I have seen that Savage Gear do these weedless lures, and I think they'll be very good to use. So I'm going to get a box of them and we'll be using them, and I think that will be much better because we'll not be getting snagged up as much. I'll always try a spinner, but when they've got trebles on, they just get snagged up so easy on rivers like here where there's debris and stuff. You need kind of a clear bottom, or the retrieve that you need to do needs to be like half depth or even towards the top end. So I'll bear that in mind for next time. Like I said, I did try and do a half depth retrieve on that far end, and we still got snagged, so it just must have been a bit shallow. But yeah, so I'm gonna get out from under this bridge because I'm probably echoing really badly. And I think we'll do the outro here, everyone. So if you did enjoy this lure session, make sure you leave a big like on it. And like I said, share it around. There's lots of people that probably watch the videos that don't subscribe. Get subscribed and let me know in the comments below if you're enjoying these lure sessions, because to be honest with you, I'm really enjoying doing these, you know, and it keeps content fresh on the channel, you know. It changes things up a bit and stuff like that. So that's why I'm, you know, I always do things like this. And I do enjoy this style of fishing, even though I'm constantly blanking, but I'm learning as I go and stuff. And yes, we didn't have a pike and we didn't get one to hold up for the camera, but you know, we had a good day and we've got some exercise. And that is one thing I love about lure fishing, is the exercise purpose of it and stuff. So that is pretty much it for this video. Do the usuals, like, share, comment, subscribe for new videos every single week, and if you're fishing, have a good one.